يوم الدين. أما بعد، إخوتي وأخواتي في الله، النفس البشرية التي بين جنبينا هي آية باهرة من الآيات التي تدل على عظمة الخالق عز وجل، كما قال لنا تعالى: وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون. وقد وصف الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه النفس البشرية في كتابه العزيز بصفات عديدة، وبين طبائعها، ووضح مدلولاتها، وأكد لنا سبحانه وتعالى بأن نجاح الإنسان في الدين والدنيا مرتبط بتهذيب نفسه وتزكيتها، وأن هلاك الإنسان في الدين والدنيا يحصل عندما يهمل الإنسان نفسه ويخضع لمتطلباتها. هذا ما قاله الله لنا سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الشمس: ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها، قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها. صدق الله العظيم. تبين لنا هذه الآية الكريمة بأن المؤمن الحق هو المؤمن الذي يتبصر بنفسه فيعرف إيجابياتها وسلبياتها، فيدعم الجانب الحسن ويتجنب الجانب السيء، وبهذا يكون قد ضمن الجنة ورضا الله عز وجل، وابتعد عن النار وعن غضب الله. هذا ما قاله لنا المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الشريف الذي أخرجه الإمام مسلم. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: كل الناس يغدو، فبائع نفسه فمعتقها أو موبقها. فما أردت في خطبتي لهذا اليوم أن أوسع عن النفس، ما هي النفس، وما أنواع النفس، وكيف يتعامل المؤمن مع نفسه. هذا هو موضوع خطبتي لهذا اليوم. My dear brothers and sisters, نفس N-A-F-S. نفس is an Islamic term which has been mentioned in Quran and Sunnah to refer to the self of human being. The self of human being is named nafs, N-A-F-S. This nafs is one of the great signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned nafs in Al-Quran, and he describes the nature of nafs, and he told us about the goal of nafs. Al-Quran also told us that the success of a human being in this deen, in this dunya and in his deen, depends on the purification of his nafs. And on the other hand, the failure of a human being happens when the person neglects his nafs and tries to spoil his nafs. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Shams. As he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the nafs that Allah created, he showed nafs what is correct, what is right, and he showed nafs what is wrong. Successful is he who purifies his nafs, and failure is he who corrupts his nafs. The ayah here is telling us that the good Muslim is the person who tries to examine his nafs in order to know the positives of his nafs and the negatives of his nafs. By doing so, he would enhance the positives of his nafs and he would improve the negatives of his nafs. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, if you did so, then Jannah will be waiting for you. As he said, every human being is toiling in this life, selling his nafs, either to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and get the reward, or selling his nafs to desires and lust and getting the punishment of Allah. In my today's khutbah, I would like to explain what is nafs and what are the types of nafs that Al-Quran talks about, and how does Muslim deal with his nafs. This is the topic of my khutbah today. Brothers and sisters, let me start by explaining what is meant by nafs. All of us know that human being is composed of body and soul. This unique combination of both body and soul forms nafs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the nafs of human being distinguished from the rest of his creatures by making this nafs responsible. Every nafs is responsible. Kullu nafsin bima kasabat rahina. This is what Allah said. Every nafs will be rewarded or punished according to the deeds the person is doing. After we understand nafs, let me talk about types of nafs. Al-Quran classified three types of nafs. Al-Nafs Al-Ammar, the commanding nafs. And Al-Nafs Al-Lawwama, the blaming nafs. And Al-Nafs Al-Mutma'inna, the contented nafs. Allow me, brothers and sisters, to elaborate very briefly on each type of nafs that Al-Quran has mentioned. Al-Nafs Al-Ammara, the commanding self. It is named Nafs Ammara, commanding self, because it is commanding the person to do evil. Allah mentioned this nafs in Surah Yusuf. وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ. I free not myself from responsibility, because nafs is inclined to do evil. This nafs al-ammara has so many so-called bad friends. The strongest ally of bad friends to this nafs al-ammara is shaytan. Satan, the devil. Shaytan tried to come to the person and try to persuade the person to do wrong. And nafs al-ammara tried to tell him, go ahead, you will enjoy what you are doing. This nafs al-ammara existing in every one of us. Adam alayhi salam, the father of humanity. Shaytan, we all know the story. Shaytan approached Adam and told him, when Allah told him, this Jannah is yours, enjoy it, except this tree. So Shaytan came to persuade Adam that this tree is so good because it will make you live forever. This was mentioned in Al-Quran. وَلَا يَا آدَمْ أَلَا أَدُلُّكَ عَلَى شَجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ وَمُلْكِ لَا يَبْلَى. Oh Adam, do you want me to show you the tree that makes you live forever? Nafs al-Ammara tried to persuade Adam, go ahead, do it. وقسمهما إني لكما من الناصحين. And Adam did. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we should never trust shaytan promises. يعدهم ويمنيهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that shaytan makes promises, but shaytan promises are nothing but deception. Because this nafs al-ammara is so compelling. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to seek Allah refuge from a nafs al-ammara, as he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min sharri nafsi. O Allah, I seek refuge with you from the evil of my nafs. This is number one, an-nafs al-ammar. Type number two, an-nafs al-lawwama. Nafs al-lawwama, the blaming self. It is named blaming because it blames the person when he does wrong. Allah mentioned this nafs in Surah Al-Qiyamah. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. I swear by the day of judgment and I swear by the nafs which is لوامة, reproaching self. This nafs is always in fight with النفس الأمارة. النفس الأمارة wants to do wrong. And an-nafs al-lawwama telling the person, don't do that, fear Allah. When Adam alayhi salam did wrong, an-nafs al-lawwama came to him and told him, Adam, fear Allah, what you did is wrong. So immediately, because his nafs is so pure alayhi salam, he and his wife supplicate to Allah. قَالَا رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, we did wrong to our nafs. If you didn't forgive us, we will be among the losers. Brothers and sisters, this nafs al-lawwama always plays very important role. The stronger an-nafs al-lawwama, the weaker an-nafs al-ammara. And vice versa. The stronger an-nafs al-ammara, the weaker an-nafs al-lawwama. So I invite all of us to call on Allah to make our nafs always lawwama. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that making jihad with your nafs is one of the steps that reaches you to Jannah. Al-mujahidu man jahada nafsahu fi ta'atillah. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his hadith reported by Imam Ahmad, al-mujahid is the person who struggles against his nafs. Now we are approaching Ramadan, which means that we are going to fast 17 hours. Are you going to endure? Are you going to show patience? Are you going to make nafs al-lawwama victorious over an-nafs al-ammara? Major prayer, for example, in the sun time right now, in the summer time, 4 o'clock Fajr prayer starts until the sunset. Remember that after the sunset, it is no longer salah, it is qada. You are making up what you missed, and this is a terrible mistake. So you have to do jihad against an-nafs al-ammara, because an-nafs al-ammara telling you, go ahead, sleep, because you are tired. But an-nafs al-lawwama telling you, no, fear Allah. Get up and offer your prayer. The third type of nafs is named an-nafs al-mutma'inna, the contented nafs. This is a very pure nafs. And this nafs, because it is so pure, that it is always so eager to meet with Allah. يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ ارْجِعِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكِ رَاضِيَةً مَرْضِيَّةً. Oh, contented nafs. Nafs. This is very pure nafs. Oh, contented nafs, return to Allah. You will be pleasing and you will be well pleased. You will be the pleasing, you will be pleasing the angels from the great job that you have done in your life. And you will be well pleased from what I prepared for you. The nafs al-mutma'inna is so great because the person trained himself so hard in this life of dunya to make it nafs mutma'inna, always, always close to Allah. This nafs has three qualities, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking us to ask Allah to have them. As he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma inni as'aluka nafsan mutma'inna. Tu'minu bi liqa'ik, wa tarida bi qada'ik, wa taqna'u bi ata'ik. Beautiful supplication that he used to supplicate Allah by saying, oh Allah, I ask you to grant me nafs mutma'inna. This nafs is always eager to meet with you. And this nafs always accept whatever decision come to me. And this nafs is always satisfied with whatever rizq you granted me. My dear brothers and sisters, allow me in my second khutbah to mention how does Muslim deal with his nafs. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ويا فوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وأحثكم على طاعته وأنهاكم ونفسي عن مخالفته. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده وأصلي وأسلم على من لا نبي بعده. My dear brothers and sisters, in general, nafs doesn't want to be controlled. Nafs wants to be free. Nafs wants to control. And once the nafs controls the person becomes enslaved to its shahawat and its lust and its desires. What are the shahawat of nafs? What are the desires? What are the lust of nafs? All of us know that nafs wants to eat, drink, have sexual pleasure, have money, cars. This is what Allah said in the Quran. زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة والخيل المسومة والأنعام والحرث ذلك متاع الحياة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the love of shahawat, shahawat means desires, lust, caprice, whims, you name it. The love of shahawat has been made beautiful for people to lust for women, children, money, fancy cars, a beautiful, beautiful means of transportation. Then Allah Ta'ala is telling us, these are the pleasures of this dunya. These shahawat, the nafs wants. The nafs doesn't want to fast, doesn't want to be wake up in the morning and perform fajr prayers. Doesn't want to help in the construction of our Islamic center. But the good Muslim who tries is the person who tries to control this shahawat, because he knows once he restrain this shahawat, Jannah is awaiting him. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah An-Nazi'at, the one who keeps his shahawat and fears Allah, Jannah is waiting for him, because it will be his final abode. My dear brothers and sisters, let me close my khutbah by mentioning that for every nafs to be under control, the person has to have three fundamental things. Number one, he needs a very powerful determination. يحتاج إلى إرادة قوية. And number two, he needs sincere dua coming from the bottom of his heart. By having these two qualities, then inshallah we are able to control our nafs, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith, Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. I invite myself and all of my brothers and sisters to memorize this beautiful dua and have our children also memorize it. Oh Allah, grant my nafs taqwa and purify it. You are the best to purify. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا وَسَلِّمُوا وَبَارِكُوا عَلَيْهِ. سمعنا وأطعنا. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. My dear brothers and sisters, before I start my dua, allow me very quickly to mention something really important on behalf of all of you. Let us sincerely, from the bottom of our heart, make dua for the father of our community, Brother Hani Shawshar, because he gave us legacy. Without his efforts, this legacy may not come into existence. This book will show you the history of Muslim from the first people who landed to Canada. You are asked kindly to get this book, and remember that whatever you pay, it will be given as a donation to food bank. So please, brother, this book is available outside in the office. Try to get it. This is number one. And number two, brothers and sisters, all of us know that the construction is a huge responsibility. And may Allah reward everyone who is getting involved in this huge project. Some people are paying efforts, physical efforts, others are financial efforts, others helping, volunteering. May Allah reward all of you. But let me remind all of us that this huge project cannot be erected without your generous donation. May Allah reward you very much for every penny you are making for this huge project, which will be inshallah for our kids in the future. We are passing away, but our kids will say, may Allah have mercy upon our fathers who made this huge project come to full fruition. And number three, brothers and sisters, I don't need to remind you, but this is something that Allah said in the Quran, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ. Always remind, because reminder is of great benefit to the believers. Your brothers and sisters in Syria are in need of your dua. The whole world make them down. The whole world make them fail. The whole world is careless about the innocent human blood shedding which is taking place in Syria. So they are asking the least we can do sincere dua from the bottom of our heart, day and night, especially these days that in Sha'ban is a holy month that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast a lot of days, many days in Sha'ban, and we are coming to Ramadan. Please make sincere dua from the bottom of your heart to make the Syrian people victorious over the oppression which is imposed upon them. يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين نسألك يا رب العالمين أن تحقن دماء المسلمين في سوريا. اللهم من اعتدى على السوريين بشبيحته فإنا نستقوي بك عليه يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب العالمين فرج هم المهمومين وأزل الكرب عن المكروبين في سوريا وفي مصر وفي السودان والصومال وباكستان وبورما وفي أي مكان يذكر فيه اسمه وتقام به شعائره. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل اسم والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذه الساعة المباركة ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا شهيدا في سبيلك إلا وقبلت شهادته ولا جريحا ولا مريضا إلا شافيته وعافيته ولا سجينا في سبيلك إلا وأطلقت سراحا. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.